OPCW inspectors go all around the world and collect many different samples.
I was curious about what goes into collecting all those different kinds of samples, so I went to find out more. Hi, I'm Katie.
And I'm Alex. We're public affairs interns at the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons.
Join us as we take an up-close look at the OPCW and discover more about what goes into achieving a world free of chemical weapons. I'm here with Joanne, an OPCW analytical chemist. So Joanne, what is a sample kit and what's it used for?
This is our sample kit, and in our sample kit we have everything that we need to take a sample when we're on a site, an industrial site or contingency operation, and we use all of these equipment to take our samples.
Inside you can find all kinds of things like lab coats, gloves, scoops, pipettes, swabs, wipes, syringes, and glassware. So what kinds of inspections are they used for?
This is our industrial chemistry sampling kit that we use when we go to chemical industry sites. We also have a kit that we use for contingency operations, but it requires different equipment.
Why is it so important for the OPCW to monitor the chemical industry?
We monitor the chemical industry mainly so that we know there's an absence of Schedule 1 chemistry, that they're not inadvertently making something, and that they're complying with the CWC and all the state bodies.
So, on an inspection, what kinds of samples do you take?
Okay, so we take lots of different samples. For instance, we'll take a solid sample with our scoops. We take water samples with syringes and tubing. We also have wipe samples that we take with swabs or with cotton wipes. We can take, say, for instance, inside of a reactor, and any other type of sample that we come across.
So now that you have your sample, what happens next?
Once we have the sample, if it's on a contingency operation, we'll send it back here to the lab in Ryswijk, and they'll send it to our designated labs. If we're on an industry mission, then the analytical chemist inspectors will prepare the sample on site in a laboratory, and then we'll put it into our GCMS.
Who knew you needed so much equipment to collect a few samples?
Just like inspectors, their equipment must travel all around the world. If you're interested in how it gets there, maybe a career in logistics is right for you.
Look for the link to our jobs page in the comments section below.
If you want to know more about the work of the OPCW, check out the other videos in this series. And don't forget, like, comment, and share.